एवरीवन, लेट्स बी स्टार्ट अबाउट सेमेस्टर 3 यूनिट नंबर 4 सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइसेस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज सेमीकंडक्टर? सेमीकंडक्टर दैट इज वी नो वेरी वेल, इट्स रेजिस्टिविटी इज बिटवीन कंडक्टर एंड इंसुलेटर दैट आर कॉल्ड एज सेमीकंडक्टर्स। First semiconductor device, or that is we call as a junction device, that is diode. Diode are generally categorized in two ways: a general purpose diode and special purpose diode. A general purpose diode, that is we call as a normal PN junction diode or semiconductor diode or crystal diode, which consists of one junction, two layers, and two terminal device. Special purpose diode, there are basically three special purpose diode are there, that is LED, that is called as a light emitting diode. Second one is photodiode, and third one is generator. In the previous you study about normal PN junction diode and generator diode. Now you are going to learn about special purpose diode, that is LED and photodiode. These are called as optoelectronics devices, because they are the combination of optics, that is deal with light, with electronics, that is special purpose diodes are LED and photodiodes are known as optoelectronic devices. More are there optoelectronic devices, solar cell, etc., which are nothing in combination of optics with electronics. These semiconductor devices are categorized in two ways. The first is a device that converts your electricity into light. It means they are light emitting diode, laser diode, etc. They are the convert electricity into light. Second, the reverse case, the devices which convert the light into electricity. They are called as a photodetector or photodiodes. So these are the two category of optoelectronics devices. The first one is called as a converting electricity into light. Second one is light into electricity. So we start with the first optoelectronics device, that is our special purpose diode, that is LED, light emitting. As it is called as a semiconductor device, so it is formed using semiconductor material. So what is principle behind it? LED that converts your electrical energy into light. But when it converts the electric energy into light, gives a visible light or infrared light when it is in forward bias. So LED is always works in forward bias. It will never work in reverse bias. If you give a reverse bias, a small reverse bias will be damage the LED, light emitting diode. Let's discuss about the construction of LED. LED is generally nothing in semiconductor diode. LED is nothing in semiconductor diode, but we know very well, in a semiconductor diodes, there is a transition of the electrons between two bands, from valence band to conduction band. And for this transition, from upper to lower energy levels, the energy is released. Or normal PN junction diode, that whenever it goes forward bias, the electron can jump from one band to another band. And when they reach to the upper energy level, they return and give the energy in the form of radiation. These are diodes. For silicon and germanium diodes, a greater percentage of energy is given in the form of heat. So it emits light is negligible because its maximum energy can be utilized in the form of heat. So it only give use a heat, not a light. Whereas the LED, that is LED is not made up by using silicon or germanium. It is made up by using gallium arsenide phosphate, gallium arsenide phosphate. In like that material, the major part of their energy will convert into the visible light or infrared light. That's why when they got forward bias, the electron can jump from one band to another band, and when they return from the upper energy levels, they give their form in the, they give up the energy in the form of light. Therefore, LED is constructed by using the material like gallium arsenide phosphide, or gallium phosphides, because they have a property to give up their major part of energy in the form of light. See, this is a construction of LED. Initially, on a substrate, an N-type layer is grown on any of the above material. On that, the P-type layer is deposited by the process of diffusion over the N-type layers. Then the metallic ohmic contact are taken out from the both the layer for the external circuits, and they are called as anode and cathode. At the bottom of the substrate, a reflecting coating is deposited so the emitted light can go towards the top. The whole construction is encapsulated in a dome-shaped transparent structure forming a lens, because this minimizes the reabsorption and also collimate the light beam to emerge out from the top. We saw that during the some situation, light will be not absorbed. That's why it is encapsulated into the transparent structure from a lens. This is the symbol of LED. Symbol of LED. The symbol of LED will be suggested like that. It is similar. The difference is the arrow indicates the emitted light. The arrow indicates the emitted light. When the arrow are pointing away from the diode, since the light is emitted by the device upon the forward bias. Remember, a light emitted in a LED in a forward bias only. LEDs are available in the several colors, but symbol is same for the whole LEDs. There is no indication of the color for the emitted light in the LED symbols. What type of material will be forms? It is depend what type of the color it forms. It depends on the See the circuit diagram. When LED is connected to the source BS, we are using one source resistance to limit the amount of current flowing through the LED, so it will not damage by the maximum by using reverse bias voltage. When the LED is in forward bias, the electrons cross the junction and they go from one band to another band, and they are recombined with the holes in the P-type material. So that's it. Electron che jare na forward bias marse. Electron che N-type madhi P-type ma jase. N-type adla jama majority charge carriers electron. P-type adla jama majority charge carriers holes. Adla jare electron forward bias marse. Electron che junction cross kare na suda se. Okay, P-type ma jase. Electrons are in the conduction band on the N side, and hole are in the valence band on P side. Hence, there is a difference of energy between these two states. One is a higher energy level, another is a lower energy level. And during this recombination, some of this difference of energy give up in the form of heat, and a part of given in the form of light. And what type of the light it emits, it depends on the material use. So this is about the LED, construction of LED. That is the way N-type layer will be as a substrate, and the P-type will be diffusion on it. And we take a two metallic contact from them, and they are called as a anode and cathode. This is symbol. The symbol, the arrow indicates the LED light emits. Then the working, it will be emits the light in a forward bias only. When forward bias will occur, the electrons are jumped from one band to another band because of the difference of energy. When electrons will return, they give the energy in the form of light. So this way the LED will emits the light.